very important. Prayer is talking to God. When we read the Bible, God is talking to us. He speaks to us through His Word. You want to know what God is saying? Then you read the Word. Sometimes we talk to God and we want Him to tell us, well, He's already written everything He wants us to know right here. So if you want to hear from God, you want God to speak to you, then we read His Word and He speaks to us through His Word. Amen?
Amen.
When we pray, we are talking to God. Amen? Prayer is vital to a Christian life. Prayer is like the air you breathe. You need it. If you're a Christian, you need prayer. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Prayer is about an intimate relationship with God. Prayer is about an intimate contact with God. Prayer is about a relationship with God. You're communicating with God. You're discussing stuff with God. You have a relationship with God. Hallelujah. If you have a relationship with God, then you can have confidence that He hears your prayers. If you don't have a relationship with God and you pray, you're not going to be sure He's hearing you because you don't have that intimate relationship with Him. Amen? You don't talk to Him. You don't call on Him. You don't look out for Him. You don't try to get close to Him. Just when you need something, oh God, help me, oh Lord. It's like, and then you're not confident that He's going to answer you because you don't have that intimate relationship with Him. Amen?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That's right. That's right. You can come boldly to the throne of God, the Bible says, and you can come into His presence with confidence, with assurance that He hears your prayer. Amen?
Amen.
You come boldly, confident, assured that He hears your prayer, and knowing and believing that He will answer you. Amen? That's right. Verse 14 of our passage says, now this is the confidence that we have in Him. We don't put the confidence in our prayer, how good it sounds, we pick the right words, we say the right things, we come to God in prayer with our holy voice on, oh Lord, help me. You know what I mean? We don't get the rhythm, we don't get going. You know what I'm saying? That's right, our confidence are not in our prayers and our words and how beautiful they sound and how eloquent you say it. Our confidence is in Him.
Yeah.
Amen. If we know that He hears us, we know that He will answer us. Do you know this morning that God hears us?
Yes.
Amen. That's faith. Yeah. You know and you believe that God hears you, and if you know and believe God hears you, amen, you know that He will answer you.
Yeah.
But if you're not sure if God hears you, if you're not even sure that God exists, if you're not sure, then you're not going to be sure of Him answering you. Amen?
Amen?
That's right. If we know that He hears us, we know that He will answer us. Brothers and sisters, God hears us, in case you doubt. He hears us, and God wants to hear from you today. Every day, God wants to hear from you. Does God hear from you? Every day. In the morning, at night, or is it once a week, on Sunday, I'm going to go talk to God, I'm going to go hear from God. Amen. I'm just asking. Every day, God is inviting you to pray. Every day, God is asking you to pray. Every day, God is commanding you to pray. If you are a child of God, God has commanded you.
Amen.
Commanded you to pray to Him. Amen. God is saying to you right now, I want you to come and talk to me. Amen? I want you to bring all your requests to me right now. Amen? I want you to have confidence and trust that I will hear from you, and confidence and trust that I will answer you. I want you to believe that I hear you. Amen? That's right, brothers and sisters. Hebrews 10:19 says, therefore, brethren, have boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus. That's the confidence that we have. That's the boldness I'm talking about. That boldness is on the basis of the blood of Jesus. Amen. Not on what I say or how I say it. My confidence is on the blood of Jesus. He saved me. He washed me in His blood. He made it to where I have a relationship with God. So on His blood, not on my merit, because I've been good all week. God's going to hear me. You know what I mean? No. Even when I'm bad, even when I'm good, even when I'm not doing so good, I have boldness and confidence that the blood of Jesus allows me to come into the presence of God. Amen? Amen. That's right. On that basis, on the blood of Jesus, I have access to the presence of God. Amen? Because of the blood, God says you have access to me. Amen? You can approach me. You can speak to me and I will hear you. You can talk to me. Hallelujah. Hebrews 4:16 says, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Hallelujah. Come boldly to the throne. Come with confidence, knowing that He will hear you. Again, verse 14, this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. Now, there it is. We've heard some conditions. Amen? There's a condition under Him hearing you and Him answering you. And that condition is that it's according to His will. That's where I lose everybody. Amen? Matthew 21:2 says, and whatever thing you ask in prayer, believing, you shall receive. Another condition. He answers your prayer. If you come believing, then you'll receive. If you just say, oh Lord, like you're doing the lotto, let's see if God hears me. Dear Lord, oh, He didn't answer that one, then He's not listening. I'll pray about something else tomorrow and something else the next day. And then we're just praying all kinds of stuff, see which one works. Say, one out of 100, He'll answer, so I'll pray 100 times, He might answer one. No. Amen. God says, when you ask, I want you to ask with confidence, with assurance, with trust. I want you to ask believing that I hear you, amen? Amen. Believing that I'm powerful enough to answer prayer. Hallelujah. That's right, brothers and sisters. That's the one condition of prayer. You must believe. That means you must have faith. Hallelujah. You must pray with faith. Your faith must be in the work of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Bible says that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and no man comes to the Father except through Him. So if you're trying to pray to God without Jesus, just try to get around Him, God ain't going to hear you. He only hears you through Jesus. He put Jesus out there. Jesus did all the work. It's through the blood of Jesus that we have access to God. It's through Jesus that He hears you. Amen. John 14:14, Jesus said, if you ask anything in My name, I will do it. Hallelujah. When you get ready to pray over something, make sure it's in the name of Jesus. And that doesn't mean that I'm just going to put Jesus behind everything I say to Him. Dear Lord, help me this and that. Jesus, like it's a button. I'll just say Jesus, and I'm saying in the name of Jesus, and that should do it, like we're pushing a button. We'll pray and say Jesus at the end. No, when He says in the name of Jesus, it means that it's lined up with Jesus. If it's in His name, then it's on everything He did, and what He says, and what He talks about. So when we pray, it's got to be in the name of Jesus, meaning it's got to be co-signed by Jesus, it's got to agree with Jesus, it has to be in His will, amen? That's right, when you get ready to pray, make sure it's in the name of Jesus. And that means that you are abiding in Jesus. You're in His name, you have to be in Him. Hallelujah, pretty basic stuff. John 15:7 says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask whatever you desire and it shall be done. Again, conditions. If you are abiding in Jesus, amen, and the word abides in you, then you can ask whatever you wish and he will do it. But I guarantee you that if you're abiding in Jesus and the word is abiding in you, everything you pray about will line up with the word of God. And then your prayers get answered. But where we're not lined up and we're not in Jesus and we're just praying for whatever, today it's this, tomorrow it's that, tomorrow we'll try this. You're not abiding. You're not in the Word. The Word ain't abiding in you. Amen?
Amen.
That's right. God says if you have a relationship with Him, that's what that abiding means. If you have a relationship with Him and you are living in the Word and the Word is living in you, you can ask for whatever you need and it will be done. Hallelujah. That's right. Verse 14 says again, if you ask anything according to His will. Amen. You can ask for anything, but the anything is conditional upon the phrase according to His will. It's all conditional. He ain't going to give you something that's going to hurt you. A lot of times we pray some good prayers, but if it ain't God's will, and the only way you're going to know if it's God's will, if you're letting God talk to you through His Word. That's why He says, if my Word abides in you, then you know what He's saying to you. Then you know what to pray about. Then you know His good will. And then now you're lined up and you're on a good roll. Amen?
Amen.
That's right. God hears your prayers and God answers your prayers, but it's based on His will. The disciples came to Jesus once and said, Lord, teach us how to pray. And the Lord Jesus told them that this is how we should pray. He said, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, and here it is, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So when we pray, we got to be, is this God's will? We got to pray according to His will. Amen. Your prayers must be lined up with His will. And life gets a lot smoother if you're lined up according to His will. Amen. He says, I've seen the saved. I've never seen them lost or forsaken or begging for bread. He'll take care of your every need. I wish He would take care of my every want, because man, I have this. But it doesn't say that He takes care of everyone. I want a 64 Chevy Impala, Super Sport on the floor, with some 13-inch Dayton's apex. People laugh. The guys who put the big meats, they're like, what are they, little tires? Bicycle tires. It just gets it lower to the ground, you know what I mean? But I don't need a 64 Chevy Impala, amen? And I prayed for one like an Indian before. I want to go out in a 64. I want that to be my last car. But see how foolish that is? He says He promises to take care of my needs and not my wants.
But I praise the Lord.
Sometimes He does give us what we want. Amen? If it ain't going to hurt us, if it ain't going to take us away from His Word. But sometimes those things take us away from God. We get in the 64 Chevy and then we're driving. Instead of us riding shotgun and letting Jesus drive, amen? We want to go where we want to go. Say, nah, we're going to show off. And then we start getting bold and brag and have our head cocked back like we're the man. And that puts the spotlight on me. God don't want that. He wants to be first. He wants to be the one people look to. He wants to see Jesus in your life. He don't want to see me. Amen? So you must desire the will of God for your life. Do you want God's will in your life? Do you know what God's will is for your life. I don't know what God's will is for your life, but in Romans 12:2, he says that the will of God is good and acceptable and perfect. Amen? The will of God for your life is perfect. I don't know what that will is, but it's perfect. And it's good. And it's going to be good for you. Amen? The will of God for your life is the best thing that can happen to you. And again, I don't know what that is, but I know it's the best. And it's good. And you're going to love it. And you're going to be at peace. You're going to be at rest. Amen? Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Give God some glory right now. So, brothers and sisters, you have to be willing to do the will of God before he tells you his will. So sometimes we want to know God's will, but when he tells us, it's like, whoa, I don't want to do that. So when he knows for sure that you're willing to do whatever he wills, then he'll tell you. He's like, I know your heart now, and I know you're going to do what I tell you to do. I know you're willing to do what I tell you to go and be where I tell you to be. Now I can tell you. But sometimes he's like, why am I going to tell you my will if you're not interested in doing it? I'm going to tell you my will, but it's for you to decide whether you want to do it or not. Tell me your will, God, and then I'll decide if I want to do it or not. He ain't going to tell you. He only tells those who are willing to do it. If you ain't willing to do it, he ain't going to tell you nothing. He ain't going to tell you nothing. He's like, you ain't there yet. You're not surrendered. You're not going to do what I tell you to do. If I tell you, you're going to do the opposite. And until we're ready to do what he says do, then he tells us will. Amen? Amen. So first you must come with faith. And you must be willing. And it must be according to his will. Verse 15 says, and if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of him. Hallelujah. He says that if you can be confident that when you ask, you will have it. When you ask according to his will. Amen. Sometimes we ask for things that sound good, but God knows that it might not be good. Amen. Sometimes we ask for things that are good and that aren't bad. But is it lined up with God's will for you in your life? We ask for good things, like, why wouldn't God want me to have this? This is good for me. This ain't going to tear me away from God. Well, God says, well, that's not lined up with my timing or what I want for you right now. He's like, do what you know that I called you to do first, and then I'll give you more. A lot of times we know God wants us to go to church. God wants us to be in his word. God wants us to be loving. God wants us to do a lot of things, but we're not doing that. And until we do the things that we know God wants us to do, he ain't going to give us any more information. He's like, you already know what my will is for you. Standard will. The basics, you already know that. Until you start doing those, then I'll tell you more about what I have planned for you. Then I'll give you more of what's ahead. Then I'll give you a glimpse into the plan I have for you. But until we do the things we know he will now, he ain't going to give us a peek into the future and see where he goes for us. Until we start obeying. Once we start obeying what we know, he's like, oh, they're interested in doing what I want them to do. They're starting to do what I told them to do. Now he needs to know the next thing. And then the next thing. And then little by little, he starts giving you more information as we do his will. Amen? That's right. Sometimes we ask for things that are going to be bad. And God doesn't want to give them to us. We don't see ahead. We don't see that this might take us away from God or stop talking to God or just things. Amen? Verse 14 and 15, I'll read them both. It says, and this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desire of him. And the key words there is like, If we know that He hears us, we know that we have what we ask for. Do you know again this morning that God hears you? That He's interested in you? He's interested in helping you? I mean, God wants to do more than we could ever imagine. More than we ask for, the Bible says. He wants to do more than we ever ask Him to do. Amen? That's right. So if we know that He hears, that means we know that He exists. We know that He's there. We know He has an ear to us. We believe it. That's faith, knowing that He hears. And if we know this, then we know that He's going to answer us. Amen? So brothers and sisters, you and I can have confidence that when we pray, God hears us and God answers us. Amen? Have you been praying about something? Does it seem like you don't get any answers? God hears us. Maybe He's working it out. You're asking Him and you don't see the answer. Maybe He's working it out. Maybe He's getting you prepared to receive what He has for you. Maybe He's trying to get you lined up through circumstances, through storms. God uses them storms to bring us to Him. Amen? Sometimes we're out having fun. We don't need God. We got money in the bank and stuff.
We got money in the bank and stuff, and our cars are running good, and our mortgage is being paid.
We don't need God. We're like, I got everything I need. What do I need God for? My husband comes home at night. We're in a good relationship. My kids are doing good. I don't need God. I'm just going to enjoy what I got. See? And sometimes God will bring a storm. Whoa! What's going on? It shakes us a little bit. And then we're like, God! See? Sometimes He uses these storms to bring us to Him. If everything's fine and dandy, again, like I said, nobody's going to come to God. When your marriage is fine, your relationship is good, your kids are doing good, your job is good, your health is good, you're young and you look good, you got your whole life ahead of you, you're a teenager, God, we're doing fine. But sometimes He'll squeeze us so we can get back on track. He said, you've abandoned me. You forgot about me. You don't love me as much as you did. You don't call upon me. You don't ask for things. You don't talk to me. You don't have an intimate relationship with me. So what does He do? He says, I want to hear from you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. That's right. That's right. God hears us. Working it out. He's lining you up. He's preparing you to receive what He has. Hallelujah. God wants what's best for you. Maybe what you've been asking for is good, but God wants better. Amen. Amen. Keep on praying. Keep on talking to God. Keep reading His Word. And let God keep on talking to you. Amen. Keep on praying till light breaks through. Just keep on praying. He'll answer you. You must pray according to His will for your life. And God's will is that you be saved, first of all. God's will is that you prosper. God's will is that you be healthy, healed of all sicknesses. God's will is that you be at peace. God's will is that you be at rest. Any one of these areas that you pray about, God will answer. Like I said, it doesn't say anywhere God wants me to have a 64. You know what I mean? So I can pray about it and I'll get it. Amen? I could. But these are the things that you can pray about that He wants and His will for your life. To be saved. To prosper. To be healthy. To be at peace. To be at rest. To be content where you are with what you have with God. Amen? And when you start doing that, and when He starts giving you that, that's all you're going to know, that that's all you really need. Once you're content, at peace, at health, you're going to be comfortable wherever you're at. We're not going to ask for outrageous things, because we're going to be content with what God's given us. Health, peace, love, rest. That's all a man really needs, is peace. If I didn't have nothing else but peace, that'd be all I need. Amen. Because then you can be anywhere and you're at peace. See, the only time we're not comfortable is when we're not at peace. We got something we want to do. There's something I need to get. There's more money I need to go after. There's this and that. Ah!
speaking now, we lose our peace. Amen.
God's will is that you be saved, be prosperous, be healthy, be at peace, and be at rest.
God wants to answer your prayers,
but He wants you to believe that He can do it. Amen. He wants you to trust Him. He wants you to be confident. He wants you to be bold. He wants you to come expecting to get an answer from Him, expecting to receive what He has for you. Hallelujah.
That's right. God answers prayers.
And He wants you to pray. He wants you to pray with faith. He wants you to pray believing that He answers. He heareth us. Amen. And if we know that He heareth us, whatever we ask, we know that we have what we ask for. Amen. I'll leave you with this last verse, John 9:31. But if anyone is a worshiper of God and does His will, He heareth him. If you're a